Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing good today. So in today's video, I have a very OG sort of a haul, which is Mars makeup. So recently I just purchased a few products. These are all purchases of mine. I did not get them on PR. I just wanted to say that. So all of these purchases I made, so I just thought of doing a quick review video. Is Mars still the same? Do we still love this brand? Is this brand improving? What are the new products? Let's dive in. I wanted to try out from Mars is their Micro Velvet Beauty Blender. Now, it's been a while since Mars released this and I was like, let me just get on with the Micro Blender because I used to love their blenders. Then I discovered Prosh blenders, which are amazing. And then I slowly, you know, gravitated more towards Prosh. But then I saw that Mars released this new blender. I was super excited. But when I went to wet the sponge, I noticed that this had a big, as you can see, tear up. So it was while I was drying my sponge with the towel that the tear up happened. So I'm like a little bit disappointed because the quality, I don't know if it's going to last me for quite some time. So I think it's just going to be a sort of use and throw product for me right now. I don't know. Let me know if you guys have tried this sponge and it has happened to you. I mean, tear ups do happen, but after a lot of use. With this one, just with the first use, this happened. So I'm like a little bit disappointed. Coming to the quality and how it performs, I would say I wish this was a bit more squishy. I like it. It blended out the product very nicely, but I like my Prosh beauty blender a bit more. I think that works really, really well. And although I love the Mars one is more affordable. I don't see myself repurchasing this. I will use it up as long as this survives, but after that I'm not going to repurchase. With this one, I like it, but it's not the best. Now coming on to the OG product of Mars that I feel like I fell in love with this product first. It was one of the best Indian BB creams that we got back like 3 years or 2 years back when they launched this BB cream. Oh my God, I instantly fell in love. And I have to tell you guys, I don't know, but I have noticed that I think they have changed their formulation. So I have repurchased this BB cream a lot. Like this has to be there in my makeup collection. So I continuously repurchased this BB cream, but I noticed that before this BB cream had a bit more coverage and this was a bit more creamy. Now I have noticed that this BB cream is a bit more watery consistency. Like first it's very creamy and then when you apply it, it kind of has a little bit of that watery texture. I like the finish still. I still feel like it definitely looks very flawless on the skin, and it's one of the great BB creams that I have. Doesn't matter, it's high-end drugstore, you know, super affordable. I absolutely love this BB cream. The only thing I would say that I found a bit different is the formulation, as I have just spoken about the texture. Also, the before BB cream, you can apply it with your fingers. Also, with this one, I feel like it's a little bit hard to blend with your fingers, and that's it. That's the only thing I've noticed about this new formulation. I don't know, they might have changed the formulation. I might be in a mistake as well. Let me know if you have used the OG, like the previous Mars BB cream, and if you feel like the new formulation is just maybe like a tiny bit different. Although again, I still love it. I again think that they need to launch more shades. The shade Biscuit 05 is my perfect shade and I absolutely love it. I would give it a 10 out of 10. So the next product that I tried out is a very recent product. So this is a new product actually. It's the Matte On Compact Powder. Now I have tried their other compact powders in the past and I do have to say all their compact powders are so amazing, guys. Like I would say they almost come to the category of MAC compact powders. I have gone through several compact powders from Mars, and considering that I have dry skin, it says a lot how high quality that compact powder is. Anyway, coming to the packaging of this compact powder, again, this feels very luxurious. Just look at the packaging, it's like rose gold. It doesn't even feel like it's like cheap, you know, that's what I mean. So the shade that I selected here is 05 Honey. Now, when I first saw the shade in the pan, I thought, okay, this is going to be a bit light for me, you know, honey, like for honey, this is not deep enough, and I still stand by it. I feel like they should release more deeper shades, But do not go by the shade in the pan. When I swatched it on my face, I noticed that this is a bit more darker. Like, I could have gone one shade lighter than Honey and it would fit me perfectly. Honey is just a tad bit more darker. Like, on camera you may not be able to tell that, but I can significantly tell it in person that this is a bit too dark for my skin tone. But anyway, coming to the texture, coming to the product, I love it. This is a very, very full coverage sort of a product, though it's not something that is minimal coverage. Yes, so if you are someone who loves to pack on a little bit of compact powder for extra coverage and you want that matte, complete matte look that looks flawless, also does not look powdery at all. I don't know how Mars does it, but they nail the formulation in complexion products. I love this powder. I can totally see myself, you know, using this on a daily basis. It looks flawless. And if you are someone who just loves to use this on your T-zone, maybe you have dry skin, you are still going to like it because of the formulation. It's very creamy. You have to, like, you have to swatch it, guys, in order to see what I'm talking about. This does not feel like a affordable product at all. It's very, very, very creamy, high coverage, looks matte and looks flawless. So again, with this powder as well, I would rate it a 10 on 10. So the next product is a new product that I tried from Mars. It is the multi-pot eyeshadow. So not eyeshadow, it's a multi-pot. So it's brown color, in it's in brown shade, and it comes with a brush as well. So there is one department has powder and the other one has a gel texture. Now I have to tell you guys, I did not, this is my first time trying this particular product from Mars, but I have seen this product, like, back in the day when I was maybe like 18-20 years. I used to use this sort of product. We used to get it in the local markets here. I used to use this product a lot back in the day and it was expensive when I got it, but this one from Mars was super inexpensive. And let me get into the formulation. So this is the product I use for my eyes today, and for my eyeshadow as well, I use the brown shade. The brown shade blends perfectly as an eyeshadow. It's not too pigmented. It blends very nicely. It gives a very nice natural sort of a look. You can use this to create a very nice transition shade for a daily look. I like the shade. So what I do not like is the cream formulation. I don't know why. I just feel like it's not creamy. Like, it's creamy enough, but it doesn't have that 100% payout or pigment, which is what I did not like. I just don't think I can use it as an eyeliner. I would go for other amazing eyeliners that I have. I like the brown powder shade a lot, but for the cream, I did not end up liking it. I just feel like the formulation is not right for someone who has been using this product since ages now. I know when I see a product like this if it is going to work or not, and today I used it. I'm like, no, this is not for me, you know. This is not something that I know I'm not going to reach out that much. So for me, I did not end up liking it. I wouldn't rate it a 10 on 10. I would say it's 5 on 10. 5 I'm giving it for the eyeshadow powder. And I like the brush as well that it comes with. Other than that, the cream gel thing did not work out for me. Now comes the most exciting part, the lipstick category. Oh my god, none does it better than Mars when it comes to lipsticks. So this is a new lip liner shade that I got from Mars. Again, this is super, super inexpensive. I think like 60 or 80 rupees lip liner. And this is the shade Brown Mocha. So this is the shade that I wanted to, you know, buy from Mars for the longest time, but they were sold out. So this is my first time trying out this shade. And of course, it's the ideal brown lip liner. It's not too cool tone. It's not super warm tone as well. It falls right in between. It would go a lot with a lot of different lipsticks as well, like nude lipsticks and neutral tone lipsticks, cool tone lipsticks, warm tone lipsticks. That's why I chose a lip liner that I know would work perfectly with a lot of my shades that I have. Anyway, coming to one of my favorite launches from Mars right now has to be the Candy Cola Gloss. So this is the Candylicious Lip Gloss, and oh my god, these are so good, guys. I already made like an Instagram reel on these. And if you are someone who have dusky skin tone and you want just a super nice hydrating lip gloss that is going to give you a little bit of pigment, but also you're not going to look washed out, these glosses are for you. My favorite is definitely the Cherry Cola shade. It's this perfect sort of brown lip gloss that I feel like looks amazing. And the best part, they smell exactly like their name, like the cherry cola. Yes, it smells like exactly like a cherry cola, and it's so good. I want to eat that candy or the ice cream that we used to have, you know, the Coca-Cola ice cream. It's exactly that, smells exactly that. Anyway, I love these glosses, they are so hydrating. Also, the shade Choco Pie is another neutral sort of a brown shade, so when you see it in the bottle, as you can see, it looks a bit dark, but when you apply it, they sheer out. The formula is very sheer, very very hydrating. So if you are someone who's in the lookout for great glosses, like these are like high end quality, guys. This is like a 10 on 10 product, very high end quality. I love it a lot. So the remaining last two products are here. Anyway, so this is the new eyeshadow. This is not new eyeshadow palette, but this is new for me. I'm not going to swatch it. I'm not going to do anything because I am going to put it in a giveaway later. So this is actually, if I can just open this up. So this is something that I got free from Mars. So I think I paid like around 1,200 total for all these products, and this was free. They gifted it to me for free, so I think they have really cool offers on their website. So if you buy a lot of products, you get free gifts as well. So this is the eyeshadow palette. I'm just going to show you guys. I know these palettes are amazing. I'm not going to swatch this or anything because again, I'll be putting this on in a giveaway very very soon, so I'm not going to use it. But I know that these palettes are good, and if you really want to get a palette like this, you can just shop for a lot more, you know, like 1200 I think, and you will get this for free. Anyway, let's come to one of my favorite products again from Mars that I have repurchased time and again. I just wanted to show you the current one that I'm using. It's finished already. This is the Mars peach makeup remover. Now this is a very very different type of a makeup remover because this is not exactly a gel, it's not exactly a oil, it's not a micellar water. It is it does exactly the work of a oil cleanser, but in a gel form that is very very travel friendly as well. Whenever I'm traveling, I always am scared to carry cleansing oils with me. This is perfect, and this actually removes your makeup, like it melts all your makeup like a cleansing balm, but it is in a gel form, which makes it super easy and not messy at all. I absolutely love it. I just think that this is one of the best products I have tried from Mars, although I would say there is a little bit of peach scent to it, and it washes off very nicely. So a lot of these sometimes cleansing balms and cleansing oils, they don't wash out that well, but this one washes out very nicely. So that is what I love. There should be really good washing capability when it comes to makeup remover, because right after using this, I go in with my cleanser and I want my makeup remover just to go away very nicely and not leave any oily, sticky sort of a residue. This does not do that at all. It kind of gives a very nice milky texture and it rubs off very nicely from the face. So that's why I like it, and I'll definitely keep on repurchasing this one. So overall, I would say BB cream, still in love with it. The compact powder, absolutely amazing. The glosses and the lip liner, truly truly good, and the makeup remover was amazing as well. The rest of the product, like the beauty blender and the iPod, okay, it's like very okay. It's not super bad, but it's not like super good also. It just falls in the middle category. Anyway, that was it for today's video. I hope you guys liked it. Let me know what was your favorite new purchase from Mars. I know you guys love Mars a lot, so let me know about that, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.